he came to Capernaum. And on the Sabbath, Jesus entered the synagogue and taught. The people were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. In their synagogue was a man with an unclean spirit. He cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Quiet, come out of him." The unclean spirit convulsed him, and with a loud cry came out of him. All were amazed and asked one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority. He commands even the unclean spirits and they obey him." His fame spread everywhere throughout the whole region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord. Dear friends, the husband came home from the psychiatrist looking very worried. "What is the problem?" the wife asked. "The doctor told me I could have no worry and perfect peace of mind if I take a pill every day for the rest of my life," he explained. "So what? Lots of people have to take a pill every day their whole lives," she replied. "I know," said, "but the doctor gave me only 4 pills. It's a joke, okay? You can laugh loud. Dear friends, today's readings talk about the reality of the world. It focuses on listening to God's voice continuously. As we all know, evil exists in the world. All of us want to get rid of the evil. There are some satanic forces that hold us from not doing good. It stays within us too. It brings division among people. God tells us 2 things today. The first one, he will take away the evil from the world. Secondly, he will speak to us through the signs of the times. In the first reading from the book of Deuteronomy, people of Israel were worried when Moses was about to die. They were terrified because they were to lose the person who had been successfully leading them through the wilderness towards the promised land. They were also going to lose a prophet who had been keeping them informed what is God's will. Then they are worried when he dies, who will tell us what God likes and not. And God promised through Moses that he will take care of them continuously. The same promise is given to us today that he will take care of us continuously. He said, "I will bring a prophet from your kids and kin, and he will speak in my name. In case if he presumes on his own and not following my oracles and commandments, he shall die. Otherwise, I will talk through him." So he said, "I will bring somebody from you." So they worried. Anxiety was, "Oh, who will be kind of leading us? How do we know God's will?" And God says, "I am there. I will bring somebody not from outside, from your own kin and kin." That's the promise given by God. And the same promise given to all of us today, that he will never leave us abandoned. He will take care of us continuously. And in the gospel today, Jesus, as we continue to see from last week and this week and next week, Jesus calls the disciples and teaches them with authority. He calls the disciples for three reasons. If you read the Gospel of Mark, chapter 3, verses 14 to 15, where he explains why he called the disciples. The first reason is to be with them. Then to preach the good news. And the third one, he gave the authority to drive out demons. And if you and I are the disciple, he calls us for the same reason. So one thing I am telling you today, that you and me have the power, the ability to drive out demons in us, around us. But a lot of times we don't realize that by our baptism, that grace is given to all of us to be with God, to preach His good news to people around us, and the ability to drive out demons. There are two reactions in today's gospel. The first one, the reaction from the unclean spirit, the man of the unclean spirit. He said, I know who you are. Have you come to destroy us? You are the Holy One of God. That's a witnessing statement. And the people were amazed when they saw this and when they heard from his teaching. They were all amazed. And let us think about what is our reaction today. How do we react to Jesus today? Yeah, I was listening to one of the speaker, and he was a priest in the family. He said, he asked the people at the back door, hey, how do you like my family? Oh, Father, it was great. Can you tell me which part is great in my family? I don't remember that. I mean, that happens sometimes, you don't remember everything. But what is amazing today when we listen to the readings, when we celebrate this Mass? Because when people were listening to Jesus, they were all amazed. They said, what is this? You have the power to drive out the demons and even the demons obey. So the same power was given to all of us. And a lot of times we don't realize. Sometimes we are trying to ignore Jesus too in our lives because we are frustrated with the things happening around us. I know. A lot of things happening around us. I'm not going into the politics. Even otherwise, there are a lot of things happening around us. We are frustrated with so many things. And we want God to demolish everything right away. But God will take care of the evil eventually. We need to trust our Him. He is fighting against the evil. And we are supposed to listen to His voice. Where is our faith in God when things don't happen in our way? That's the difference. Like, we have some 50 people here, I think so. But anything you take, we have two opinions. For some it is good, for some it is not good. For some it is right, for some it is wrong. So there is going to be a fight between good and bad, right and wrong, good and evil, all the time. And God will take care of us. And He will take care of the evil. That is the promise God gives us today to all of us. I will take care of the evil. He says to the evil, quiet. And He will take care of that. And He will continuously focus on us and help us and give us protection in our life. So today, how do I react to God? How do I react to Jesus? What is amazing when I come to celebrate this Mass? What are the amazing things that happen in my life today? It's exalt us, exalt God into our hearts. So today, let us think about and ask God's grace to understand that He is with us all the time. He never leaves us abandoned. Take out all our frustrations and worries and anxieties. He will be with us. As human beings, we have a lot of anxiety and worries, but believe that He is with us all the time. When we suffer, He suffers with us. When we are joyful, He is joyful with us. He is always with us there, forever there. So let us believe on that and try to realize that He will be with us all the time in our life. For that, let us pray in this Mass. nourished by this, O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just and a duty of our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without fear we acclaim.
John and Seth from Rusty, whom we remember this past day.
Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all.